of the Empire. Criminals on the fringe, like the Wookiee gladiator Lorik, the medical droid 41 Vex, the Twi'lek bounty hunter Ascara, and the human smuggler Pash, along with Pantoran Slicer Lula, played by Shanana Banana. And now, they will die. Okay. And with that, we are going to be jumping right into our game today. Joining me now, as I mentioned, we have the Wookiee Gladiator, Lorik, being played by the one, the only, the Ham Solo.
Hello.
We also have
my screen's off.
The recently freed droid, 41 Vex, being played by Reem Arcturus.
Hello.
We have Twi'lek bounty hunter Ascara, being played by Old Man Millie.
Hello.
And we have the human smuggler Pash, being played by Zero.
I'm here!
Dancing.
All right. As we begin and picking up pretty much where we left off last time, Lula, you had just met up with this band of rogues as they were escaping from the palace of Teemo the Hutt. On the run from his guards, you now find yourselves having ducked inside a cantina trying to take cover. You know the guards will be showing up right behind you, and it's only going to be moments before they arrive. Now, inside this dark and dingy, typical cantina on a Twi'lek, or on a Tatooine small town, what would you guys like to do? As you look around the cantina, you can see a Twi'lek dancer up on the stage, just kind of dancing for the one or two locals that are inside, avoiding the afternoon sun and trying to get away from the dust and the heat. Meanwhile, a bartender is behind the bar and he's cleaning a glass, and it's not really getting particularly any cleaner than it is right now. You think it's the cleanest dirty glass that he has in the bar.
What's the question again?
What
are we
would
all
you guys like to do?
What I'm doing?
You know that it's only moments before the guards probably try to track you down inside this cantina. So what would everybody like to do?
Well, I'm putting my review of the bar on TripAdvisor.
On TripAdvisor? Brings up DataPad, starts writing the review.
I want to get my dance on. My dance.
So Lula is, she knows she needs to get away, but she, at the same time, is always hungry. So she kind of makes her way into the cantina anyways to actually grab a snack for if she needs to leave or go anywhere. So she makes her way into the cantina.
Oh, you guys are already inside the cantina. So, would you like,
okay,
for example, would you like to try to blend in and act like you're just a local belonging there in the cantina? Would you like to try to find a place to hide in the cantina? Would you like to try to get ready for a fight? What do you guys think you'd like to do?
So she kind of sneaks in quietly and is just kind of just blending in, like looking at everyone's like food,
okay,
around the tables.
I think
with Z on her side.
I think with my character, I'm going to be in one of the darkest corners, just watching out for anybody who might actually shoot me, particularly from Timo's kind of crew.
Sounds good. So why don't we have both Lula and Ascara? Why don't you guys go ahead and make a stealth check for me?
Oh, gosh.
And you know what? I'm going to give you guys a boost dice on that because it's little, you know, it's dimly lit in this bar. It's dark and it's dingy. So you guys would be a little bit hard to pick out.
And yeah. Oops.
All right. So, Lula, you try to blend in, but one of the locals who's there sitting at the cantina watching the show, he has this most delicious, like, loaded, baked space potato on his plate that he's about to dig into. And it's got everything. It's got, like, chopped Nerf bacon bits, chives, sour cream, butter, and it's like loaded. It's at least like 4 inches tall. And you are sitting there, and all thoughts of stealth go completely out the window. You,
drooling from her mouth.
You are drooling from your mouth watching this guy, and it actually throws him off a little bit. Now, meanwhile, Ascara, she is trying to get into this dark corner, but she's got this big gun that she's carrying. She's loaded up with all this badass armor, and she keeps trying to, like, wedge herself into the corner, but as she does, she knocks over, like, the microphone onto the stage, and it just makes a loud, like, clang. The music stops for a second, like, the dancer stops and looks at her. Now, you guys did each have a little bit of threat on your, or advantage on your roll. So, how would you guys like to spend your advantage?
Can I use my advantage to use Z as, like, a cute distraction from me being noticed?
Yeah, we'll say it's not a distraction to keep you from being noticed, but if you want to have Z start running around the bar, your little robot dog start running around the bar, you can choose someone else to give them an extra boost for their role.
All right, I will give Ascara a boost.
Okay. So Ascara, for your next role.
Knocking over all of that.
Yeah.
Oh, great. Thank you.
You're welcome.
For your next role, Ascara, you'll have a little bit of a boost. And then 41 Vex and Pash, what do you think you guys would like to do?
Do we know about this ship yet?
Sorry, what's that?
Do we know about the ship that exists?
Any ship that exists.
Do we know about it?
You guys haven't heard anything about any ship yet.
Oh, can I sort of talk to people, say, and ask them about a ship?
Sure.
Cool.
Go ahead. Yeah. Go ahead and make a, let's see. Go ahead. How would you like, do you want to be charming? Do you want to be threatening? Do you want to act like you're buying? How do you want to ask around for this ship?
I would say, like, I am interested in, if you have a ship that lets us, travel somewhere.
Okay. So let's call that a negotiation check. All right.
Okay, I am looking for some travel. Do you have a ship? I'd be like, yeah, we do. And then, oh, cool, where's it docked? And then and they'll tell us, and then we'll just go over there and steal it.
Yeah, so go ahead and scroll down on your character sheet and find the negotiation skill, and go ahead and roll those dice. However, everybody in this bar is either a little bit drunk or a little bit worn out from the day.
It's okay, I'm drunk right now.
So they're not exactly looking to be pestered by someone about a ship. That's going to add a setback to your roll. So go ahead and make that negotiation roll.
negotiation PR.
Pending his outcome, if he ends up upsetting someone, would the Wookiee not step in and help him?
Potentially, but that is up to the Wookiee. you go around asking around the bar for a ship for sale, but you know, in your typical Pash brashness, you're kind of like, ship, we need a ship, anybody got a ship? And everybody just kind of ignores you at that, but you also have generated a little bit of advantage. How would you like to spend your advantage?
I want my ship. Give it to me, suckers.
Okay, so I'm going to say that with your advantage, you end up noticing that, like, at the mention of the ship, the bartender's ears seem to perk up a little bit.
Mm-mm.
So what do I do with the advantage?
With your advantage, you happen to notice that one key element that the bartender seems to notice that you're asking around for a ship.
So can I go over and pester the bartender?
Well, right now, I want to find out what Lorik does.
Lorik is kind of wary from the day.
And, he's fur, it's at least like 115 degrees outside.
Exactly. He's aware that most people are intimidated by him because of stature and reputation. So he's just gonna casually sit over here and mind his business for the time being.
Okay. I'm gonna have you make a cool check.
A cool check, okay.
How cool you are.
Go ahead and you know what? I got it right here. So you succeed with one success. So
awesome.
You are sitting there looking very cool.
Very cool.
And you know what? You just kind of sit down, do your own thing, and you are ready for just about anything that's going to walk in through that door.
Sounds good.
So Zero, Pash heads over to the bar, and he's just about to strike up a conversation with the bartender. Reem, did we find out what 41 Vex is doing?
Am I even allowed in the bar?
You are allowed in the bar.
I'm sitting with the Wookiee, I guess.
Okay. So
I'm just sort of waiting for something to happen.
Let's have you go ahead and make a cool check also. Alright. So you succeed with a threat, but also with a triumph.
Ooh.
So a triumph is kind of like a critical success. So tell me how you want to spend this triumph. Basically, you're sitting down at this bar. You do have one threat. So I'm going to have you take one strain. As you're running through the streets, it's kind of like the dust and the sand has been clogging in your servos. So if you go to your character sheet, you can mark your strain from 0 to 1. And then you have a triumph. Triumph is, like I said, it's like a critical success. So how'd you like to go ahead and spend that triumph for me?
I'm not sure what you mean.
You can do, not anything, but what would you like to do that would be something that your character may not be able to do typically otherwise?
I'm going to attempt to drink a margarita. It's margarita.
Okay.
What type of margarita?
Very bold.
A bold margarita.
A bold margarita.
This is a bold margarita. And you know what? One of the ingredients in this margarita has a double use. in being able to clean engines, like degrease engines. So as you drink this, you don't actually drink it, but it just kind of washes all down over you, and it clears out some of the gunk that's been clogging up your gears and servos. It's been a while since your last maintenance, really. So on your next check, you can use that triumph to upgrade one of the greens in your dice pool to a yellow. So say you have like one yellow and two greens. For that one roll, you'll have two yellows and one green.
Okay.
All right. So now that we find out what everybody's doing, Pash, as you begin heading towards the bartender to find out what is going on.
I'm there. I made it.
Let me just figure this out. As you head up to the bar, you notice that there are four Gamorrean guards that walk in.
Are they are they good? Are they bad? Are they friendly?
These are like the pig guys that typically find employment in a hut. And they enter the bar and they begin looking around. And all of a sudden they can see Ascara and Lula standing in the middle of the floor. Like, at this point Ascara is kind of getting desperate to try to find a shadow big enough and dark enough so that she can hide with her big gun and her armor. And Lula, she's still distracted by all the food. She just doesn't care at this point. So the guards let out a squeal, and you see them begin to charge towards Ascara and Lula. At this point,
oh, no.
I would like everybody to roll initiative.
Initiative. Where the hell?
Where is initiative?
So yes. if you go to combat,
yeah.
So Lula, Ascara, and Pash, you guys will all roll vigilance. Lorik and 41 Vex, you guys can roll cool because you're kind of sitting down preparing yourselves for whatever happened.
Oh my gosh, mine's just a one.
So, I want to roll vigilance, right?
Vigilance?
You said vigilance, right?
Yep, vigilance.
I did it. I think I did it. Oh, I don't know where it is.
Yep.
Oh cool, I got two greens. I hope that's good. I hope I won. I just don't keep on spinning here.
Okay. So, yeah, Pash, it looks like you see these guards come in right away, so you're going to be the first to act. How would you like to react to these guards as they begin to charge towards towards Lula and Ascara?
Where's Pash?
He wants me to give him a second. So, that's fine.
Wait, okay, I'm back.
You good?
Okay, so they're going to... What was the thing again?
The guards are about to attack Lula and Ascara. What would you like to do about it? You're the first one to act. You've always been bit of a quick draw, and now it's coming in handy.
Am I near a table?
Sure.
At all?
Sure.
I'm like a table in their way, like try to like push the table over into their path.
Okay. Yeah.
Is that a possibility?
Yeah, absolutely. Go ahead and make a go ahead and make an athletics check for me.
Toss that table.
But
check
but
it.
If
here.
But if he does that, given that my character is so skittish anyway, wouldn't I go in the defensive?
You can have your character do whatever you'd like them to do.
Okay.
Like, what are you doing? Stop that!
Well, it's not my fault, Shannon. It's just, hungry and eating every single thing in sight.
Hey, I can't help it that I'm always hungry, okay?
Always hungry. Like, she's eating everything that packs.
I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna order whoever kicked the table to calm down, so I'm gonna throw my leadership.
Okay. Pash, you go to kick the table, and it turns out these tables are bolted down. You try to kick it over, and it just doesn't budge. It just doesn't budge.
Ouch!
However, you ended up with that two advantage. Yeah, you ended up with two advantage. So I'm going to say that with that advantage, it actually provides you pretty good cover, though.
What type of now, cover is there for a bolted down table?
Maybe you just weren't strong enough.
Now, Ascara, you performed a leadership check. So you want to tell everybody just to keep their cool, keep their heads about them, or what would you like to do?
I'd like to tell everybody to keep their cool about them, especially since the barman's attention was on us trying to find a ship, because I suspect that the barman is actually a spy.
Ooh.
Discriminate against the barman, I see.
Okay, now...
The poor barman.
Thanks to Ascara there, having everybody keep their cool. Ascara, you can pick one person to give a boost dice to there. So who would you like to, like, particularly mention this to? Would you want to focus this on Pash since he tried to kick the table over? Or who would you like to specifically have try to keep their cool?
I want Pash to keep his cool.
Alright, so Pash, on your next roll, I'm going to add an extra boost dice to that.
Because he needs to chill out.
Alright.
Chill out, Pash.
Chill out, Pash.
41 Vex, it looks like you're up next. How would you like to react to this new threat of the Gamorreans in the bar?
Well,
Gamorreans.
I don't really want to get up close to them for obvious reasons, and no one's really wounded right at the moment. So, I'm going to hide behind the Wookiee.
Okay.
Lorik's like,
Hey, Lorik is used to having you patch him up, so I'm sure he is gonna do what he can to stay in front of you.
Aww, that's sweet.
Or maybe he'll use you as a shield and he can patch you up this time.
It'll be like when Chewbacca carried around C-3PO on his back.
Something like that, yeah.
Yeah.
Just be careful, because Lurik's kind of old, so...
I don't want...
Not much caring he should do anymore.
Alright, like... so 41 Vex, you kind of take up a defensive position behind Lurik, and Lurik, it happens to be your turn next.
Well, with these very threatening establishment, I am moving towards my friend. I am going to stand up in a non-threatening manner, and I'm maybe just gonna inch closer to over here where
more than an inch.
Yeah. I'm gonna you know inch closer to my friend Ascara.
Okay.
Just in case there's any sort of conflict.
Okay. And I believe, Lula, that makes you last. What would you like to do next?
So, Lula... Lua starts making her way. She, like, just kind of casually sees the group all together over here, and she just wants to say hello to all of them. Kind of, like, not really recognizing the threat behind her. She's like, hi, everybody! What are you guys all doing? I see, you all, you know, it notices, Pash kind of kicking a table, and she kind of goes over to him and asks, like, if his foot's okay. You tried to be cool, but I'm sorry it didn't work out. And kind of like casually makes her way over to the table that got knocked over, like behind.
Okay.
So like she nonchalantly gets into cover. How about that?
Sounds good.
Nonchalantly, but is like mocking Pash at the same time.
All right. And with that, the Gamorreans are going to begin their attack. They're each going to maneuver once to get into range.
That's a huge maneuver.
It is a maneuver. It's a maneuver from... They're going to actually maneuver twice, because they're going to maneuver once to get into... from medium range to short range, and then they're going to maneuver once again to get from short range to engaged range. And that'll cost them 2 strain to do that. And then they are going to begin their attacks.
Well, good thing I got this table here to protect me. That doesn't move.
Well, you know what? This table that doesn't move is going to actually give you a little bit of protection, Pash. So,
what type of protection? It's like an inch of metal.
Considering my character's really panicky, I decide that that's it, and I decide to do a ranged attack.
Okay. Once the Gamorreans go, we'll come back through to your turn, and then you can absolutely do that.
Okay. Sorry.
No worries. No worries at all. Yep. So they have basically some, you know, like knobbed sticks that they're gonna try to beat you guys down at with and drag you back to Teemo's palace.
Tim, do you want to explain how the combat works?
Yeah. So basically, the way it works is, you guys get one maneuver and one action. A maneuver can be used to move a range band, like from short to medium, or vice versa, and then from, if you want to make a melee attack, from medium into engaged. You can make a second maneuver for 2 strain, or you can use your action as a free second maneuver. If you want to kneel, stand up, get into cover, equip or unequip a piece of gear, that's all a maneuver also. Instead of moving, you can also aim as a maneuver. You can even aim a melee weapon if you'd like. It's kind of just like, just take careful aim with whatever you're using, and that'll add a boost dice to your roll for the attack. Now, if you haven't moved or made any other maneuvers, you can in fact double aim, which will give 2 boost dice to the attack roll. But you can only ever do 2 maneuvers, you can't ever do more than 2 maneuvers, and you can only ever do 1 action. So, Pash. This Gamorrean swings with his beating stick. And he misses you completely, however...
Because of the table!
He does miss you because of the table. Unfortunately, with his triumph, he demolishes this table that you've been hiding behind.
How do you demolish the table that's bolted to the ground?
Because he's that strong. You think getting hit by this guy would really, really hurt. Now, the fortunate thing is that this guy cannot take another swing at you because he has already acted. The unfortunate thing is that his friend can take another swing at you. And this time, you do not have the table to protect you. He will fail.
Yes!
But he's gonna... yes. In order for you, as you dodge his attack, it leaves you sprawled out on the ground. So you're kind of laid out on the ground, and he just kind of is... He holds you down with his foot, and he's kind of aiming with his next attack to bring it down right on your head.
Oh, gosh.
All right. Get
clobbered.
Now, Lula, you are the next target. You do get clobbered. You're kind of not exactly sure what's going on here, and you get bashed for...
Why can't we all be friends?
You get bashed for 7 damage, minus your soak.
Okay, do you want to explain soak to everybody? Because I don't think that was explained.
So everybody has some soak, and they also have wounds. So you can take wounds up to 1 past your wound threshold. Once you go 1 past your wound threshold, your character isn't dead. You are simply incapacitated. It's like you're knocked out. Your soak, for example here, Lula got hit for 7 damage. However, what's your soak, Lula?
It's 2.
So we'll subtract the soak off the damage she receives. So in this case, it's 7 minus 2, so she would take 5 wounds.
5. Alright. So, she's a little bit, like, dazed.
Probably not feeling too good from that.
Being attacked, not expecting it all to happen. And, she's just like, whoa!
And Ascara, this other Gamorrean, has seen that you kind of have this big gun that he doesn't like the look of, so he's going to try to bash your head in.
So I take I shoot for his right leg.
Well, he actually misses you. You see this? He's making this big right hand overhead swing. And you're able to dodge it, and he just misses you completely. It does throw you a little bit off balance, so on your attack, I'm going to add 1 setback roll. Alright, and that will bring us back to you guys. Pash. You guys can go in whatever order you like. So, Ascar, if you would like to go first, you can go ahead and go first.
I want to see what the Wookiee does.
All right. I think the team's rooting for you, Lorik. What do you want to do here?
I am going to attack this burly marauder right here with my what is my weapon? It is a vibro axe.
Oh yeah, this is gonna be.
Ooh, yeah. So,
I am going to attempt to cleave him in the head.
Yeah, he's basically already standing right in front of you because he was trying to bash, I think this is the one that's actually got Pash pinned down to the ground. And,
yes, this is good.
So you don't need to really move or anything to get in range with him. Do you want to aim or at a boost dice?
Boost dice. Okay, I'm not sure how to. Okay, I'm not sure how I would do that.
Well, if you want to use, since you're not really using any maneuvers any other way, unless there is a way you want to use them, then go ahead, just tell me. But if you don't have another way you want to use your maneuver, you can go ahead to use it to aim, and that'll add a boost dice for you.
Okay.
So I've got that loaded in, and then all you need to do is just swing your vibro axe.
I think I'm just gonna swing the vibro axe.
Swing away.
Okay.
Bam! Huge hit.
Ooh, dang! Knocked out. Hopefully. He's would hurt. Not want a Wookiee attacking you with a vibro axe.
He is not feeling great. It turns out when a Wookiee hits you with a vibro axe,
woo!
You do not simply take 2 aspirin. Call him in the morning.
No.
So you can spend your advantage how you want to. I will simply point out that it only takes two advantage to perform a critical with your vibro axe, and you have three advantage. So if you wanted to use two of those to crit, it wouldn't be a bad way to spend them.
Then that's how I will spend them. Yeah. That sounds good to me.
You take this vibro axe and you bring it right down on the head of this Gamorrean, and it just splits like a coconut.
Oh gosh.
And
bam!
He just goes down hard. Pash, you feel the weight off your back instantly lifted as the Gamorrean falls off of you.
Is Pash here? You said to give him 2 minutes.
Okay, that's fine. But bad. Anyway, Pash is no longer pinned down by the Gamorrean that was kind of stepping on him. All right, who would like to go next?
I will.
Go for it.
Okay, how far is the distance between me and Lula?
It's probably just barely in medium range. It would take like 2 maneuvers for you to get over there. Basically, the way to think about the range bands is engaged range. You can only communicate via whispering, okay? Short range is basically talking with your normal voice and someone could hear you easily. Medium range is talking with an elevated voice. Long range is you have to be screaming at the top of your lungs to be heard. And then extreme range is you can't even communicate via voice. The range bands are intentionally a little bit abstract.
Okay. So it would take 2 movements to get over there. Can I take a little strain, extra strain to get over there?
You would take 2 extra strain to get over there. Now, I will point out that another way to spend advantage is you can also recover strain at a rate of 1 per advantage on whatever roll you'd like.
Okay.
Okay. So you're going to go ahead and move over next to Lula. And then what would you like to do?
Hi, robot droid. Hello.
I would like to use my medicine skill to heal her.
Yeah, you're going to try a little bit of first aid on her.
Yay.
Let me know when you're ready.
Let me see here. Lula, what is your wounds at?
5.
Okay.
Well, yeah, I have 5.
And what is your wound threshold at?
12.
Okay. So because she's not over half her wound threshold, it's a little bit easier roll for you. All right, so go ahead. Oh, and you know what? You get to upgrade one of your greens to a yellow, so make sure you go ahead and do that, Reem. So you might want to just fill in the dice at the top of the sheet instead of just clicking your medicine.
I can't just use that upgrade one.
Oh, yeah, you can use that.
Okay.
All right. So, Lula, you heal 3 wounds and 3 strain if you have any.
Ooh, wait, what was that, 3 wounds?
You heal 3 wounds and 3 strain.
Sorry, I was distracted by Pash's tons of typing and sending. So, 3 wounds. I'm at 2. Oh, and I don't have any strain, so. So Lula looks over at the robot and like thanks the robot with a big grin on her face, like. Thanks, robot. That's really kind of you. I appreciate it.
You're quite welcome, miss.
All right, so Passion 40 or Lorik and 41 Vex have gone. Who'd like to go next?
Can I go?
Absolutely.
In order to defuse the situation, I want to negotiate with them to see if they could put one of their one of their toughest warriors against the Wookiee. So I want to do negotiation.
Do even ask the Wookiee. Oh, dang. I don't know if there was a...
I'm going to roll it right
added
now.
Added to it. Okay.
It's not so much in a negotiation as it is you pointing to this Gamorrean that got his head split open, and you go, "Did you just see that?
Oh my god!"
And this convinces the Gamorrean that he absolutely has to get revenge on this Wookiee, and so now he just wants to go right for him. He's gonna make sure that he does to this Wookiee what this Wookiee just did to his friend. Because his friend was only one day away from retirement. Just one day away.
Can the rest of us get popcorn whilst we watch the Wookiee?
Pirate full benefit.
Starting to have some questions about this friendship here, you know?
Alright, who would like to go next? We've got Pash and Lula left.
Okay, so what can I do?
What do you want to do?
Let's see. How many Gamorreans are still alive?
Three.
Okay, then. Am I, like, wounded at all?
You are not wounded, I do not believe.
Yeah, I'm the one who got hit.
I think two of them swung at you, and then they all missed.
Yeah.
Okay, so...
I was the unfortunate one.
Can I, am I going to assume that all the tables are bolted down?
Well, it depends on the strength of your kick, let's
say. Assume all of them are bolted down.
Did you eat your space Wheaties this morning, Pash?
Oh, no. So can I do a, can I do one of those awesome, evasive rolls to one of the tables? Like, one of those very cool rolls that everyone loves to see in movies?
Yeah.
In movies?
Yeah,
I just want to roll.
That'll
like,
be one maneuver.
Roll.
You will,
he's like Space Bruce Lee.
Yeah, so you'll...
The Dark Souls roll?
You can maneuver from engaged into short range... And then for your second maneuver, it'll be to take cover behind another table.
Okay, so that's what I want to do. I want to roll from my currently dead table to a table that's alive.
Okay.
My currently dead table.
God, it was so sad.
In a live table.
Okay, so what do I have to do?
Okay, is there anything else you want to do?
Am I able to shoot after that, or...
So, if you want to unholster your gun, that's going to be one maneuver. So, you could move to the table, but not quite get into cover yet, unholster your gun, and then shoot.
So, can I just get to the table, take cover, and unholster it, but not shoot?
You don't have the maneuvers left to unholster it, but you can, you can unholster it first thing next turn.
Okay, that's what I'll do then. I'll just get to the table and take cover.
Sounds good. Wait. And Lula, I believe you're the last one up.
Alright, so after being healed by the awesome medical droid, Lula, you know, she's kind of, you know, she's happy that she got healed, but she's ready to actually do something about it now instead of just looking around.
Fine.
So she, can I do like a perception to see if there's any like anywhere to hack the lighting to like dim the lighting in the area so it can make it harder for them to see to
yeah,
try to attack.
Yeah, I mean, you think you see a panel just next to the bar that probably controls, you know, the house lighting Or if not the house lighting, something interesting.
Okay. How far is that panel? Is it two maneuvers, one maneuver away?
It's probably two maneuvers away. It's probably medium range away. Because you have to get all the way over to the bar.
Okay. So she uses those two maneuvers. Would you say it's like right there?
Sure.
Ish. So I take strain. Is that how many strain again?
Two strain.
Two strain. And strain two. And then for her action, can she hack the panel?
Yeah. Go ahead and give me a computer's roll. One sec. Let me load up the dice.
Sounds good. I hope Wookiees are really good at seeing in the dark. Just wreck havoc on them.
All right, go ahead and roll.
All right, computers, and roll.
Yeah. So all of a sudden, the bar goes from dimly lit to not lit at all. You have one advantage there. How would you like to use your one advantage?
I'm going to give it to the Wookiee. Whatever boost dice, is that a boost dice?
It'll be a boost dice, yeah.
Yeah, boost dice to the Wookiee.
Alright.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
The lights go out.
Hopefully you can smell them. You can smell them, you don't even need your sight. Just go wreck havoc.
The bartender, who's already been a little bit frantic, the people are tearing up his bar. Now you just hear him start to yell, "Hey, what's going on with the lights? You damn punks!"
Lou's just whistling in the corner.
And now the good thing is, with the lights out, it makes it much harder for the Gamorrean guards to hit you guys. The bad news is, with the lights out, it makes it much harder for you guys to hit the Gamorrean guards.
God damn it, Lulu.
Hey, you know, you win some, you lose some.
All right, and I think with that, we will go back to the guard's turn. All right, this first guard, he is going to take a crack at you, Lorik.
Oh, boy.
All right.
And he is going to miss.
Ooh.
Now this next guard comes charging over past Ascara, and this is the one who is determined that he was going to bash your head in. He can kind of smell where the other Gamorrean guard is, though, because these guys smell pretty bad. So he's got a rough idea about where you are. So he's going to use the advantage from the previous guard, and he's going to get a boost dice from that.
Oh boy. Ooh.
And he is gonna crack you in the head just like he said
he was.
Oh,
no!
Oh, man.
Not your head! Not your beautiful face!
He hits you for 10 damage. What kind of soak do you got against that?
What kind of soak do I have? My soak is 4.
Okay, so then you would add 6 wounds.
Wait, is that for Lorik or Ascara?
That is for Lorik.
Oh. Oh, dang.
Okay.
It's like Trouble Space Program all over again.
So 6 to wounds then.
Correct.
Okay. Okay.
Vex is like, yes!
That hurt.
Oh no!
Alright.
It's all Lulu's fault.
And this last guard's gonna come up to you, Vex, because your eyes are kind of glowing there in the dark. So he sees, like, hey, here's an easy target, might as well. And he's going to take a crack at you. And he will also connect.
No!
He will do 9 damage, but in the dark he kind of gets himself stuck on some of your, like, pointy bits. And so he's actually going to hurt himself as he swings at you.
Can you define these pointy bits?
So what what do you have for
sorry,
stealth?
Sorry, couldn't help
myself. 3.
Okay, so you are also going to take 6 wounds.
Dang,
least,
all these 6 wounders over
die.
Here.
The table,
the table didn't die.
The table did live. Alright, so this will bring it back to you guys. Who wants to go first?
Oh,
can I go first?
You absolutely can.
Maybe Lulu could turn the freaking lights back on?
Can I shoot in the direction of the Wookiee?
You want to shoot? Is that what you said?
Well, blindly shoot.
That just sounds all sorts of bad. Let me shoot in the direction. All right.
Do I roll gunnery or?
So you currently have a carbine, I think it is, which is a heavy weapon. It's going to be ranged heavy.
Yeah.
However, you are shooting to someone who is engaged, so that means one of those dice is actually going to be a red dice. So I need to clear this quick. Alright, now go ahead and roll your ranged heavy, or roll your rifle.
Okay.
Okay.
Oh, boy.
Oh, no!
So
oh,
you, boy. You miss, but you have one advantage. How would you like to spend your one advantage?
Can I give a boost to the Wookiee?
You absolutely can.
To his brawl.
Yeah, for sure. Alright, who'd like to go next?
The Wookiee just needs to go Hulk status on them. Yeah!
Okay.
Hulk smash! Wookiee smash!
I will go next if that's okay with everyone.
Sure.
Yeah.
I am going to swing my vibro axe once again.
Okay.
So
I think, did you want to aim again or anything?
Okay, I'm not sure how to.
It's really, imagine with a melee weapon, imagine like really focusing on like hitting a baseball or something. That's kind of the same thing as aiming with a melee weapon. It's not necessarily aiming in the sense of a gun, but it's the same principle. You'd like take a breath and really line up the shot and really focus on making the connection.
Gotcha. Okay. Okay. I am, well, I mean, I aimed for the head last time on one of these guys. So why not do the same?
Okay. So that's going to be one boost dice for the end aim. And then you've got one boost dice from Lula and one boost dice from Oscara.
Oh.
So go ahead and roll that vibro axe whenever you are Alrighty. Ready.
Whack 'em hard.
Here we go. Oh my goodness.
Oh, bam! Dang.
Nice.
I mean, he had a head at one.
Yeah.
Can he use like some of that success to accidentally hit the other one?
Oh no. So the way it works in this game is when you attack a minion group, like these guys are just mooks. So the minion group has one total health pool. So when you attack a minion group, you're kind of attacking them all at once, as long as it makes sense. So in something like this, Lorik, you just kind of swing right through both of these guys.
Oh
my goodness.
Dang, you are like definitely Wookiee smashing them.
And they just kind of drop right on the floor.
He's like enraged.
That'll teach them for cracking me over the head.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Lula in the corner is like saying, "Woohoo!" Here you go. Yeah.
Oh god.
Now this other Gamorrean that's over here, he just saw two of his buddies go down, and he sees this like glowing red Wookiee eyes turn towards him in the dark.
Oh, that's so scary. Holy
and
God.
He looks like he's getting ready to bolt as soon as he gets a chance.
Oh, wow.
Alright, so Ascara is gone and Lorik is gone. Who'd like to go next?
I will.
Okay. What would you like to do?
So this guy's weapon is stuck somewhere, right? Like in the ground or something like that?
It was more like when he was meleeing with you, he like ended up jabbing himself with all that pointy stuff.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
I think I'm just gonna... How far away is Lorik?
He's at short range.
Okay, can I just go over there to him and then attempt to heal him?
Absolutely. So that's going to be one maneuver to get over to him. And then you can try to heal him also.
Try to inject him. I'd be careful. But don't get smashed. It's a furious Wookiee on our hands.
All right, Lorik, you heal 3 wounds and 1 strain.
Nice, okay.
That's like some pretty good healing capabilities.
And 1 strain.
Yep, if you have any. All right, Lula and Pash, we have you guys left.
Well, my character, he's pretty smart, so he's going to defer to Lula.
He's going to what? To Lula?
Defer to Lulu.
To defer?
Yeah, defer. So you get to go first.
Oh, I get to go first.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
You go first.
Oh, okay. So wait, we only have one more left? One guy left, huh?
Yep.
That was Lulu.
So since so Lula notices there's only one guy left, and you know, she has Z by her side, just kind of just chilling there, waiting to do stuff. She kind of sends off Z to see if he can just kind of run around the last guy standing in a circle, so like he's more noticeable to find for everyone else in the dark.
Because
Z kind of like lights up a little bit.
Sure. So, yeah.
So how do I command Z? Because I know he doesn't like to listen very well.
Yeah.
I forgot which tab.
Give me a leadership to tell Z to head over there.
Leadership?
Either leadership or computers, whichever one you might like.
Oh, I'd rather do computers. Tennis for sure. Computers?
Sure.
All right. Well, he may not even listen to this computer check, but let's see. Mm-hmm. All right. Ready?
Yep. All
right, let's do this. Oh! Triumph!
Oh, yeah. So how would you like to spend your triumph?
I just noticed when I went to heal, I used mechanics instead of medicine, which are right next to each other.
I think it's the same dice pool, though, isn't it?
Is it 1 yellow, 3 greens?
No. Mechanics is 1 yellow, 3 green. Medicine is 2 yellow, 2 green.
Oh, it's okay. You still succeeded.
Okay.
So, for my triumph, can I have... I'm not sure. Can I help the medical droid out with Z somehow?
Okay.
I don't know, give the droid, because I know the droid was hurting a little bit, so maybe it's have Z run over to the medical droid and try to link a connection somehow, or I don't know. I'm trying to wing something here.
Okay. Vex, you feel something like brush against your leg, and next thing you know, there is this what looks like a droid dog running past you. He's taken his tail and he's kind of plugged it into this port on your leg. And at the same time, he's run over to the last standing Gamorrean, and he is blinding this Gamorrean with his lights.
Yeah!
Now, because you're not used to just all of a sudden being hacked by another droid, with the threat, this actually causes you 2 strain, 41 Vex.
Oh, sorry. Sorry. Sorry about my droid dog.
Did this heal any wounds or anything, or do anything?
Not yet.
Okay.
Right now, it's as you guys are kind of establishing this communication protocol, it's just kind of jarring that another droid is trying to hack into you, basically unannounced. Eventually, though, he is able to share some what seems to be top secret communication with you. You're not exactly sure what all of it says, but it gives you an idea about how to heal more efficiently. And that means on your next healing check, you can upgrade one of your greens to a yellow. We'll do that with the triumph.
Sweet!
And Pash, I believe that brings us to you. You are up last. What would you like to do?
Okay, so I'm pretty much tucked away behind this awesome table, right?
You are. You are tucked away behind this awesome table.
Like, this table is unstoppable. It's like bolted to the ground. It's got that firmness to it.
This table is strong unstoppable table. And unbreakable right up until the moment that it gets broken.
Okay, do I have any decent line of sight to this Gamorrean?
Oh yeah, you can see him.
I just see him. I can see him perfectly.
Oh, well, you can't see him perfectly.
He's illuminated by Z.
Yeah, he's illuminated by Z, so that is removing the setback you would otherwise have on this one guy.
So, am I able to take aim and shoot at this dude?
Yeah, you absolutely can.
I want to do that. I want to take aim and shoot at this dude. I want to like aim so hardcore. Going to shoot him, and I'm going to impress Lulu as much as possible.
Alright, go ahead and roll either your pistol or your ranged light.
Let's see. Where am I going? How do I do this? What do I want? Ranged light?
Yep.
So ranged light, not ranged heavy or gunnery?
It would be ranged light, or if you go to your weapons, it's going to be your pistol.
Combat?
Yeah, combat, and then under weapons, it'll be your pistol.
Okay. Hey, let's do this. We got this, people. We got this. Let's roll those hard sixes.
Roll six!
Come on, hard six, baby!
Nice.
All right. What is the critical rating on your pistol?
Don't know. Assuming I have to go to weapons again.
Okay. It looks like the critical rating on your blaster pistol
3?
Is 3. Yeah, it's 3. Would you like to crit this guy?
Oh, hell yeah. Suck a bitch.
Crit him. Crit him. All so right. Bad.
So with your last remaining...
And destroyed my table.
With your one remaining advantage, you can heal 1 strain if you would like. And as you take aim with your blaster pistol, thanks to him being illuminated by Z, the droid dog, you line up the shot and just kapow! And the Gamorrean falls over with a smoking hole in his chest.
Oh, hell yeah!
Nice!
Yeah. Nice.
Okay, Lulu, how was that, girl? Do you like that? Yeah?
That was cool!
Look how awesome that was. Mates, Oscar are jealous. Yeah.
Very nice.
And with that, the last.
This was for you, table.
That was for you, table. R.I.P. table. R.I.P.
So with that, the last of the Gamorreans are defeated. However, you guys are pretty sure that probably won't take long for Teemo to start sending more of his goons after you to try to apprehend you. As you guys are just kind of catching your breath, and Pash is making sure that he can lean on this table and it's not going to break underneath him.
Lean on me when you're not strong.
I gotta make sure this table does not break. This table is life.
He jumps on top of it and like just keeps hopping on it to make sure it doesn't. Right,
my goodness.
While you guys are catching your breath, the bartender comes out from behind the bar and he says, he flips on the light switch as he walks out from behind the bar. The house lights come back on, brighter than the dim lighting that they were before. And he says,
I guess you folks need some transport off this planet in a hurry. Good news for you is that I happen to know that there's a freighter in Landing Bay, Auric, right now. The bad news is that its Captain Trex is an associate of the Hutts and won't exactly just let you on board. The other bad news is that the reason I know it's still in the landing bay is that it's got a broken hypermatter reactor igniter and won't be flying anywhere until it gets a new one installed. He goes, I bet old Vorn over at the junk shop, though, has one.
And as he says this, he points out the door, and he turns back to you, and he gives you this wide smile. And he says,
now get out of my cantina!
Can I kick him in the nuts on the way out, please?
Lula just goes over, not even listening to a word that he said, and just asks him for any kind of food. I didn't even listen. Like, as if it like went right over her head, and then she just goes burning it in her.
I just want
any food, please, and I'll leave willingly.
He goes, food? You already destroyed my bar. I'm gonna have to deal with the hut now, and you want food? Get out!
And he spins Lula around and gives her a kick in the butt that sends her like a couple feet forward.
Ah. She just looks around, pouting, with a big, like,
oh god,
sad lip. But then she sends off Z to grab the food that the other people were eating earlier on the table that looked really delicious.
Z comes running out with this half-eaten, half-blasted, loaded baked potato. There's some probably, like, one or two good bites left on the plate.
Yeah.
Z just comes running out of the bar. With the plate still in between his teeth.
She's like, thanks, Z. You're my best friend.
Oscar, if you want to roll to kick him in the nuts on the way out, you're going to have to give me a brawl check.
Brawl check? You fail!
You roll to kick him in the nuts.
Goes, oldest trick in the book. I learned that week one. We call that the Tatooinean goodbye.
Oh, gosh. Well.
You roll to kick him in the nuts, and he just sidesteps it, and you whiff. Fortunately, you don't fall on your ass, but you miss kicking him in the nuts.
You get thrown out with me.
Okay.
Come join me, Oscara.
Yeah, Zero, you don't get any XP for kills. XP is based on story, so killing the bartender will not give you more XP.
I will not.
Just your experience.
I think Lorik's kind of maybe comprehending whether or not he should just take out the bartender anyways, you know, no witnesses sort of thing.
He did give us information.
He did.
So, I mean, that's a plus. He didn't have to do that.
That's true. That's true. He can't help it. He's still in that Wookiee bloodlust.
In that rage.
Blood rage. The Wookiee blood rage, yeah.
So then Lula takes her baked potato and she offers it to the Wookiee. Just so maybe he can calm down. She goes over to the Wookiee. Here you go. Oh. I get angry when I'm hungry too.
Take my
baked potato.
I do take your baked potato.
Okay.
He nods approvingly. He nods approvingly.
Oh. Maybe. She just like does a smile.
A bit of a Wookiee growl. A low. Yeah. There you go. Yeah. Yeah.
I see a blossoming friendship here.
All right. So we can't shoot this guy, I guess.
As you guys make your way
what happened?
Out onto the streets of Moschuta.
So massive.
It is massive. It's the biggest little city on Tatooine.
This place is huge.
Oh my god.
Gotta go like 20%.
They gotta zoom all the way out practically.
Yeah, zoom to 50.
My character's stuck.
Wow. That's pretty cool.
So, as you guys make your way out onto the streets, you're all once again blasted by the heat of the twin suns of Tatooine. I want everybody to take 2 strain or increase your strain by 2.
How do we do that?
On your character sheet where it says strain, click the up arrow twice.
Strain.
Where are you, strain?
Z-strain. It should be right next to your wounds.
Yeah.
Where are you, wounds? Oh, there you are. So, there's no up here. Oh, I see. So
you have a threshold and then you have your current. So your current should be at least at plus 2.
1, 2. There we go. We did it. Victory.
No, right. Pash, you can't bring the table with us.
So how well do we know this city? Do we know it well?
You guys know this city pretty well. Basically, you know, all the labels that you see on this map, you guys know about already. You guys have been doing work out of this city for months, if not years now, for Teemo. And you can see all the way over on the western side, there is Teemo's palace there. He lives in a giant seashell. Yep.
Seashell.
Now, you guys were just given advice that the junk shop might have the part you need if you are going to steal a spaceship. And the spaceship is itself, in fact, in Landing Bay, Oryk.
Oh, it's the Millennium Falcon!
Ew, it's a Y-1500. It looks horrible. Can we get an Earthship? You have something that looks better?
With what money? What money are you going to buy a new ship with?
No, we're not buying ships. We're stealing ships.
Well it's the only ship we can steal.
Stealers can't be choosers.
Exactly.
It's true.
Show us nothing over in Landing Bay Besh?
Landing Bay Besh is currently unoccupied.
Could we not rob the junk shop?
I'm not saying it's not possible.
So could we not set at this table?
Now, very important question: does this starship have a table on it?
Does it have a table in the ship? That's all that matters.
Well, here's the thing about YT-1300 is that they're highly customizable. So this ship may have 0 tables on it, or it may be nothing but tables on the inside.
There we go.
The only way to find out is to actually get inside the ship.
Can we get the full table modification on it?
Full table modification.
You can check. I mean, if you were to get something like that, you know, the junk shop might have it.
What if we were to sell Lola to the junk shop owner?
You would have to see if he was in the market for any hungry Pantoran do-nothings.
We just sell the Wookiee. Like, Wookiee's made for good labor.
Wookiees, no, it looks like Lulu and the Wookiee are just going to team up against, no, I'm just kidding. Quit trying to sell us and kill us!
While everyone else is discussing what to do, can I start repairing myself?
Sure.
Oh, that's true, yeah.
Find an outlet somewhere.
Yeah.
You know what? You would have a what's called an emergency repair patch. It's kind of the same thing as a stim pack, but for droids. So, if you want, you can go ahead and use one of those, and it automatically heals 3 wounds without a roll. It's like a maneuver to use.
Okay. Can I do that now?
Yeah.
All right. So, do we have
like any engineers in our group that could probably fix this ship without the piece, or do we definitely need the piece?
We should do a heist.
You want to do a heist?
I'm down for a heist.
Lula's just there for, you know, she's just gonna be following whatever crew this is, but she actually kind of wouldn't mind grabbing more food along the way. Just saying.
But couldn't Lola like be a distraction?
Only if she's willing to work for some good food items, so just saying.
Nice, does she have that like nice sexy body that'll turn on and distract the junkyard dude?
No.
No?
Nope.
The Wookiee has.
Yeah. Use that sexy Wookiee growl.
Yeah. That's what it is. That's the Wookiee persuasion.
I can just picture him just like strutting in. Like...
All eight feet of him.
Yeah. Hey, oh, you know? God. All right, shall we head over to the junk shop then, right? Yeah?
Yeah.
Slowly, but surely? I know we can't really move our characters over to there, but...
Well, we could always go to the bounty office.
I want to take the Wookiee to Victoria's Secret just to prepare.
Get the Wookiee some lingerie.
Is that a thing? I mean, I'd be curious to find out now if it's a thing.
Do a perception check for some Wookiee lingerie.
I mean, like, I'm sure lingerie exists, but I mean, Wookiees are already nudists.
I know they are.
That's true.
I feel like a Wookiee putting on lingerie would be the same thing as like putting on sweatpants and it being sexy.
Hang on, if a Wookiee is naked. How could we not get the Wookiee to do the helicopter
impression? Oh, gee. I think we've killed Millie.
Oh, you're crying. So we've lost our bounty hunter. Our bounty hunter has
I've just got this image of a Wookiee just swinging it about.
Oh, jeez.
All right.
This is And after murdering four Gamorreans, we laughed outside of the cantina for a half hour.
There we go. Hey, we're bonding, okay? We are bonding in laughter.
Oh, my goodness. That's what it is. Oh, jeez. Jesus, Reem. Well, there you go.
Just make sure you stuff all that hair in a bra.
Oh my god, man.
Poor Lulric.
Do we have enough money to buy this thing?
I think you guys have some money in your character sheets.
Oh, I thought we were dirt poor.
You are dirt poor, but dirt poor does include some money.
Where's our money show?
It's gonna be in your character sheets.
Oh yeah, under credits. I see credits. Yep.
Oh, I'm credits.
Yeah, I have 225.
It's in the bottom? No.
It's towards the top under character. Under character info and then character. Or at least that's where I'm seeing it.
Yeah, so underneath where
I have 500.
Yep.
Nice.
I have 675.
Ooh. Do the helicopter! You failed!
No, my character's dirt poor.
Alright. So let's talk to the junk shop guy. Let's see, maybe it won't be too much. Maybe you can Wookiee intimidate this junk shop owner.
Well, I think what we should do is probably have a stir up, maybe talk to the junkyard dude,
flirt.
Flirt. She is a Twi'lek after all, and
Twi'leks
are known to be sex slaves.
Twi'leks are known as the universal galactic sexy species. When they're wearing heavy battle armor and have a giant gun, I don't know. I think that needs to be a certain kink that you have. But
he might like it. You never know.
You never know.
He might be into Wookiees too.
Wookiees might be his jam.
It could be.
Human male smugglers might be his jam.
Yeah.
Yes.
All right, let's do this. What's his flavor?
There's no humans here to smuggle.
All right, so you guys are making your way over to the junk shop.
Yeah. We made it. We're here.
You guys make your way
through the sandy and dusty streets of Tatooine. Every now and then, you know, a big gust of wind just blows up, and it's just hot air right in your face, and you get a mouthful of grit after it passes, and it's just miserable. Finally, you make it to the junk shop, and you duck inside, and as you duck inside, you know, it's immediately obvious that the scrapyard out back, and from this low poor stone building, this guy gets a little bit of business, but he gets just barely enough business to stay in business. Once you step inside, you see basically this hunched over old human male kind of behind this counter, bent over, and he's kind of mumbling to himself as he's like counting machine parts. The man glances at you, and then he looks over, and there's a R4 droid right next to him. And as he sees you, he starts yelling at the droid. He gives it a kick, and he goes, "You stupid droid, you're supposed to tell me when I have customers." He kicks the droid hard. The droid almost gets knocked over, and it just gets sent reeling, and it kind of runs out back to get away from him and do whatever it does out back.
No dice roll for the kick.
This guy's kicked this droid so many times, he can just do it whenever he wants to.
Cool. Are there any tables inside?
There is no table. But he rests his elbow on the counter of the sales counter, and he gives you guys the best forced smile that he can give you, and he goes, "Welcome, customers. As you can see," he points at the racks of all the shelves around his little shack there, "we have any part you might want on Tatooine. What can I do you for?"
Are there any other, like, places in the city that would probably sell the piece that we're looking for?
The place that would sell the piece you're looking for is right here in this guy's shop.
So there's nowhere else that we could buy it?
Unlikely, but you could look around if you wanted to.
Because I was figuring maybe what we could do is as we haggle with this guy, we could say, like, "Oh, they're selling this at this other place for cheaper. Might as well go over there to try and drive down the price."
So he wants to haggle.
Well, how much do you know about hyperspace matter reactors?
I know quite a lot. Like, that's what I know for. I got into my real-life job of accounting.
Well, then you know how hard it is to find one of these.
Oh, jeez.
So, like, Lula just nonchalantly, after seeing the guy kick the droid, she just says, like, out loud, "You know," because she has Z right next to her, "you know, if you're nicer to your droid, they'd probably work better for you. Just saying."
And he's like, "Oh, I'm sure that's a sweet fairy tale your parents told you, girly, but this here's the real world, and some droids need some motivation."
Fairy tales? Which ones?
The one where the droid needs to get kicked to get to work.
Oh, I've never heard of that one. Interesting.
All right. So he says again, what can I do for you folks today?"
"Is it okay if I, like as myself, I look around to see if there's any surveillance-type devices?"
Perception check.
Yeah, go ahead and make a perception check for me.
Okay, we're going to perceive this.
Can I roll coercion and grab the Junker by the scruff of his neck? And basically threaten him, saying he has to...
Intimidate him.
Yeah. Okay, so first, Pash, you look around and you do see, like, one security camera kind of over the door you guys came in and pointed at the sales counter.
So there's only one, or I only see one, right?
You see one, yeah.
So there could be more.
Potentially, but, I mean, this one looks kind of crappy, and, if there was more than one, it'd kind of be surprising.
Okay, cool.
All right, now, go ahead and make your coercion roll.
Ooh.
Uh-oh.
So,
oh, no.
You grab my scruff. And you try to threaten him. He goes, "Listen, every scum that comes in here, they all try to get parts the same way at first, grab the junk dealer by his scruff and try to threaten him. It's happened so many times, I usually get at least twice before breakfast now."
Is it breakfast time yet?
No. This is late afternoon, it's almost dinner.
Can we not offer him the Wookiee now?
So we just...
Can we offer him the Wookiee now?
So when you threaten him, what exactly do you say to him?
I say, you know what the device we're looking for, basically give it now, otherwise, what's his name? Timo is going to come down and ruin his shop.
He goes, "Well, I don't know what device you're looking for. As you can see, and he kind of gestures around the shop, I got a lot of shit in here. What exactly is it that you want?
So, can I not turn around to him and say, look, don't play coy with us, otherwise I'll set the Wookiee on him.
He goes, I'm sure we can make a deal, but what is it that you're looking for?
It's like, question mark.
Do you want some fuel rods? Do you want some, conduit cabling? Do you need some fuses and joining boxes?
What do you need again?
I got one hypermatter reactor igniter, but I can't sell you that, because that's, Trex is going to come pick that up. But pretty much anything other than that, you know, I can make a deal with you.
Was that the one we needed?
Yeah.
That reactor thingy, Majini.
Sounds like a part.
Say that we are here to pick you up for Trex.
Okay. Go ahead and make a deception check for me.
Ooh.
Deceive like no one else. Deception, con?
Yeah, it should be just a straight deception roll. Okay, so...
Oh, dang. Ouch.
You failed at the deception with a despair, which is like a critical failure.
Yes!
However, you have two advantage. How would you like to spend your advantage?
What can I do with the advantage?
You can use it to heal two strain. You can give a boost dice to someone else on their next roll. Or you can think up something and let me know, and we can see if you can do that with two advantage.
Well, I fear this guy is not going to, right now he doesn't seem like he's going to barter with us. He seems like, the type of person that's a jiggle jams.
That has a jiggle jam.
He's like the new jiggle jam. So I think I'm going to. I want to boost the Wookiee because we might need to shoot this guy in the face.
Okay.
Or we might want the Wookiee to just like clobber him again and just break him into pieces.
I'm just gonna kill this guy.
I guess we're just gonna kill this guy then.
Well, I mean, that's really up to you, I guess. Because they're all giving it in your
hands. Oh, jeez.
I mean, he is kind of abusive to droids. That's not nice.
Yeah, but at the same time, we can't really go around killing random people.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think it's...
How about before he does that, my character steps in and offers him a table instead?
I got this really strong table. You can have them all.
You can even bolt it to the floor.
There you go.
So you're going to try to trade him a table for this part?
Well, it's either that or being whacked off by a Wookiee.
Oh, God. Poor Lovric.
Can I just sneak up to the guy and sedate him or something?
So,
are you that kind of droid?
I'm a
that's droid.
That's true.
A medic
droid.
Yeah, that's true.
Both a stealth and a medicine check. I would let you.
Oh
do
boy.
That.
Do it. Try it.
I assume I have to do stealth first.
The droid sneaking up,
yeah,
slowly to like inject him.
So
oh,
you
nice!
Succeed with three threat. So
geez.
You're able to sneak up behind him, but as you do, Pash begins to give you away. He begins to point at you, and he's like, hey, what is he? And then he kind of catches himself, and he stops. and
oh, thanks, Pash.
Yeah,
thanks.
You're welcome.
You need everything.
The Vorn.
Can I just sedate Pash instead?
Vorn, the junk shop owner, begins to turn around as you begin to sedate him. So that's gonna upgrade one of your purples to a red with your 3 threat.
Ooh.
Oh no. Oh boy.
So now does he roll for trying to inject him?
Yeah, you're gonna roll. It's gonna be a medicine check to try to sedate him now.
All right.
Oh.
Oh.
What?
Wow.
No way.
Amazing. So right as he turns around, you just like not like jab him, but he turns around and all of a sudden he's got like in his field of view just these big blue glowing droid eyes like 2 inches away from his. He's like, what the? And then it's just like the tiniest little poke right in his neck with a needle. Just like, and you jab him with the medical probe and he just drops. He's like, it's... He goes, I needed to build a wall to keep the droids out. And he passes out on the floor.
That's what you get for abusing droids. A needle in the neck by a droid.
Wow.
Now, that did cost you 1 strain, though, in order to simply sedate him without injuring him. So that threat is going to give you 1 strain.
Okay.
Lula just says out loud, oh, you go sleepy now. Good night. Good night. Oh, good job, droid. All right, so do we
do we do anything for the triumph?
How would you like to spend the triumph?
Can we take, well, not only the piece we need, but also can we convince his droid to come with us?
You want me to hack him?
So, like, as he goes down, we'll say for the triumph that the piece kind of falls out of his pocket on the ground. So that part you need.
Like the tiniest thing in the world?
It's like the size of, you know, a couple of big batteries, but he's wearing cargo pants. So it falls out of his pocket, and all you need to do, Vex, is just reach down and pick it up. As you do, the other droid comes out, and he sees the owner knocked out on the ground. He just kind of gives you a whistle.
Is it a good whistle or a bad whistle?
It's a good whistle. Like, this droid's been beaten up quite a bit. He really doesn't have any love for this guy.
Maybe not bring him with us, but set him free, let's say.
No. I think we want to bring him with us. We could always use more friends.
We can always use more friends. Aww.
I want a sex droid.
No.
Well, if you want to set him free, it'd be a mechanics check to try to remove his restraining bolt. And if you wanted to bring him with you, you'd have to try to convince him to go with you. You'd have to give him a reason for wanting to go with you instead of just hanging around waiting for the shop owner to wake back up or maybe find his own fortune in Tatooine.
Can I have Z help out?
Or the world, get to see all different types of tables.
Could I not give him an upgrade, like, to make sure he's alright, like, so, like, roll the mechanics?
You could, but the amount of time it would take you to, like, upgrade him would take quite a while. Like, the shop owner would probably wake back up by then. Now, if you just wanted to, like, pop off his restraining bolt so he could go wherever he wants and do whatever he wants, that would only take, like, a minute or two.
Yeah, I think I'm just gonna take the restraining bolt, and if he wants to join us afterwards, so be it.
Who has... So I've got a yellow and 3 greens
and mechanics. I've got yellow and 3 greens and mechanics as well.
Oh, okay, perfect.
I have 5 greens or mechanics.
I've got 1 yellow and 1 green.
Alright. whoever would like to remove the restraining bolt, go ahead and make a mechanics roll.
I guess I'll do it, since I was the one who sort of knocked him out.
Oh, there you go. You saved him.
Yeah. You just equip the right tool on your arm, and that restraining bolt just pops off.
GG, Vix.
See, this is why you'd be nice to droids. Lula says out loud.
Well, can we put our own restraining bolt onto it now, so it'd be our
You're free to become our new slave!
Now you're our slave. Oh, that's not how you make friends.
It worked at PAX.
Since I got two advantage, can I get rid of some of my strain?
Absolutely. You can reduce strain at a cost of one strain per one advantage.
Okay, thank you. I'm doing them both.
Alright. So we're just going to let the droid do its thing, whether it wants to be free or give
it the option. Well, you can try to convince him to come along if you want.
And what check would that be in order to convince him?
Coercion?
Well, if you were coercing him, you'd be threatening him. You can try to charm him. You can try to negotiate with him. You can try to leadership with him. Those are all kind of social skills.
Mm-hmm.
Can Lula use Z as an advantage to show how Z is a friend of Lula's and not like a...
If you wanted to do that, I would have you try to give Z an order to try to convince him that that because Z is there, it would be good for him to come along. However, that risks Z having a mind of his own and ignoring the order.
I could try, unless someone else wants to try to charm the droid.
Well, I have charm.
You want to charm him?
I have a rank of one, and a yellow and a green for charm.
Can I do something really unusual? Can I just shoot the droid?
No! We just freed him!
I want to shoot the droid.
We just did this completely free, and you want to shoot the droid.
We're going. Oh, God.
No!
We're spinning.
All right. So, Ascara, you want to shoot the droid, right?
Yes.
No!
And who wants the droid not to get shot?
Everyone else.
Everyone else.
I do not.
Okay.
I do not.
Yeah.
Ascara, I think you begin to level your gun at the droid, and then all of a sudden there's just like four other arms that grab onto the gun and kind of lower it down.
Tables are apparently more important than droids.
Yeah.
Oh. No. Alright, well, we saved the droid. Alright.
Again.
Ash, you're going to charm him? You're going to charm the droid? Because you wanted him to come along anyways, right?
Should I charm him? Do I have good dice to charm him?
You said you did.
Any dice can be good dice. All you need is one success.
There you go. Do it.
So I want to roll
charm him.
Charm, right?
Roll
Tell
your
him
charm.
How much fun he would be to be working with the... Alright.
Did it work?
Yeah. So what? Tell us what you tell him, Pash. Tell us what exactly you told him to convince him to come with you guys.
Okay, let's see. So it'd be like, hey, baby, how you doing there? I know your owner treated you pretty harshly before. And it wasn't really that cool. I've seen harshness before.
So basically, he's harassing the droid. What the hell? Let me just shoot the droid.
As I talk to this droid, I'm like patting his head, just stroking the droid, stroking its arm things.
So, as you're doing this, eventually the droid decides to come with you guys, and he lets out a series of beeps and whistles. Now, Lula, Vex. Basically anybody that could speak droid, you can tell that these beeps and whistles are him basically saying, well, if I'm going to be stuck with an idiot, I might as well trade up. And he rolls right over the top of Pash's foot. And Pash, that causes you 2 strain.
Oh, gosh.
George, can I kick him now?
Can I kick him now?
No.
Oh. See, the Wookiee will not allow that. Mm-mm.
I can't kick him?
No, no. The Wookiee says no.
No. No. No.
Oh.
So
that's
as,
not a ranged light.
As you guys follow the droid out of the shop, he turns around to you guys and he says, you know, if you guys were going to steal that ship, I suppose you already know that first you have to remove the docking lock on it from spaceport control.
Oh, nice.
Did we grab our part that
yeah,
we needed?
Yeah, I believe.
Okay.
Yeah, I have it.
Vex
okay, good.
It, yeah.
Thanks, Vex.
Now, can this does this droid have like the ability to hack the spaceport control and undock the ship?
Maybe you should charm him.
Yeah, you could probably talk him into it, I'm sure, Pash.
I don't think we want Pash charming anything anymore.
Oh, 2 fails and a despair. He backs over your other foot.
Yeah.
I don't think you're gonna convince this droid.
Alright. So the droid kinda leads you guys up to the spaceport control area. And as he does, you guys arrive right in front of the building for
oh my
spaceport
God.
Control.
Ooh.
Dum dum dum.
Oh boy.
Oh, dang.
We still can't move our characters. So are these things like guarding it? Are they droids as well?
Yes. Standing in front, guarding the entrance.
Ooh.
You see 2 droids.
So why is this starship, like, lamped down?
Standard docking procedure. It's to prevent theft. Now, you know, apparently they got the crazy idea that some people might be conducting thievery of starships on Tatooine. And also, it's kind of like a safety procedure to make sure that any smugglers or anyone who doesn't pay Imperial tariffs doesn't just come, unload their cargo, and then jet out again.
Can I sneak up to one of the droids and hack into him so he shoots the other droid?
I like that.
You can try that. You know, it's for right. that, I would have you kind of do the same thing that Reem did with Vex on the last one. So he would have to, you would have to do a stealth check, and then you okay. would have to do a computers check to try to slice into him. Now, if anybody would like, they can kind of help out with this if someone wants to provide a distraction or...
Ooh, me! Me! I mean, I'm a good hacker.
There you go.
I can help.
The perfect candidate.
Wait, where's our droid at?
What if we were to send Pash to talk to them?
And... yeah, no.
He's really good at talking to droids.
That's probably a really great idea. While they're beating the crap out of Pash, someone can hack into them.
Yeah. I made it inside. I'm in. See, I made it.
No, you did.
Yeah. See, I'm inside now.
Okay. Should we roll computer then?
First. Okay. So who's gonna be sneaking up and who's gonna be doing the hacking? And who's going to be doing the diversion?
I've sneaked up.
Do you want to sneak up?
So who? I can. I can sneak up with low. How many? What's your level of computers like?
Okay, whoever is sneaking up, Go ahead and roll a stealth check
stealth
for me.
Check.
Okay, hang on. There.
Okay. Ascara, you were not able to sneak up on them. They notice you, but they're just kind of doing patrol. So as you approach them, they just kind of stop you and say, you know, this is a restricted area. Please present Imperial identification to enter. You also have one advantage, so you can spend that in a way you would like. Do you know how you'd like to spend your advantage?
Yeah, I'd like to send the Wookiee.
And you can't blame him. That is. I mean, it's practical. Yeah.
So I'd like to send the Wookiee on a rage whereby he bashes both the heads in.
Well, so Lorik, you see Ascara try to sneak up on the guards, and you see the guards stop her and, you know, challenge her for entry. And as they're doing this, you see Ascara kind of give you the head nod, like the get over here head nod.
Alrighty.
What you do is your choice, however.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So is this place under Imperial control, or is this place run by Teemo?
This place is under Imperial control. However, you know, Teemo is effectively in control of the entire city. You imagine that in order for Imperials to run and control the spaceport, there likely would have to have been some understanding worked out between the two parties.
So getting a bit violent here, yeah. Might not be the
best. So maybe not, but as a Wookiee, I don't think I can really intimidate. Well, I don't think I can really intimidate droids.
Well, that's person, not sure. True. We saw in the films that Chewbacca did a hell of a job intimidating a mouse droid.
That's true. Okay.
Yeah, but that's Wookiee mouse win. It's not like it's a security droid.
Well, he can try it. This is an RPG, and in an RPG, you can try whatever
you
would like to.
You can do whatever you like.
I think I'm just going to be I'm gonna be a stereotypical Wookiee, and I'm just gonna bash somebody.
Yeah.
So you're just gonna walk up to him and start swinging?
I'm just gonna walk
Wookiee
up to him.
Smash.
His head is looking rightly exposed, and I think I'm gonna take a clean swing with my vibro axe.
Okay.
No patience.
Go ahead, and everybody, roll initiative again.
Oh gosh.
Initiative.
Here
actually, you know what? You know, these droids, they would have still been challenging Ascara for identification. So if you just want to walk up cold and swing at one, I'm going to let you just go ahead and do it.
Oh boy. Oh boy.
Do it.
Okay, do it.
All right. So you swing and miss,
oh, no.
But you get an advantage. How do you want to spend your advantage?
Can I swing again?
you can't swing again, no.
Okay, what else? Okay, what else can I do then?
What's Lola's special ability?
Lula is good at mechanics and at hacking.
So
and
whilst he's
do-
so whilst he's doing that, can't Lola now hack?
It's not my turn yet.
Oh, sorry.
I can hack. She can hack.
So maybe the Wookiee gives Lula the advantage.
Or if you want to recover strain, I don't know if you have strain.
Yeah, you can give the next player a boost dice with your advantage if you would like.
Let's do that then.
Okay. As you swing and miss, one of these droids, kind of, you hear him emit this shrieking sound, and the whole building begins to shout an alarm. And suddenly, from deeper inside the building, two more droids emerge, and they take up defensive positions. And all the droids begin to level their weapons at the party. And I believe that is where we will leave this session.
Aww.
Oh, man.
Already? Damn it, I was about to go hack them. Just about to hack them.
Yep.
Damn it!
It's been our 2 hours. Guys, this has been a really fun session. I like leaving it on a cliffhanger like this. I think it's really great. You guys have been an amazing party. Thank you for coming out and playing with us. And yeah, I think we are going to try to do this semi-regular.
Alright, well, I mean, do we want to... So, did you guys... What did you guys think? Of I mean, this it's first a lot... session, everybody. Like,
it's a lot of fun. It's it was fun. You know, my first time doing anything. I've always wanted to, but yeah, I'm glad I got to do this here today with you guys. It was awesome.
Yeah. Awesome.
So, thank you guys for having me.
No, thank you for joining us.
Absolutely.
So, mods, if you guys can give a shout out, we've got a couple of streamers in here right now. So, The Ham Solo is a streamer. Old Man Millie is a streamer also. So, Zero. And then Reem, I've seen stream a couple times too. So, can you give shout outs to everybody who is here in this group today? They all did an awesome job for their first time playing, which is great. You guys did awesome. So, yes. Thank you. Thank you, mods. You guys should totally give these awesome people a follow. Just saying. We're going to try to do these sessions, what was it, Tim, every like month or so?
Monthly, depending on how it goes. If we have a lot of interest, we might go twice a month. But right now, I think once a month would be pretty good pace.
Yeah, so once a month. So this is something new that we're starting up. This is, we have these same characters that you see today that you can actually jump in and play. So if anyone is new to this and would like to next session to play one of these characters, you can jump in, you can message me or jump in on our Discord, and we have all the information and everything in regards on there. You can let us know about that, and if there's a character you're interested in and you want to play next session, we will set the date and the session on Discord too. So yeah, definitely, this is open for everybody. As you see, these are all first-time players in here, so... And they did an awesome job. You got to see a little bit of the rundown of how it kind of works and how we work and how we play, how the game goes. You pretty much just need an imagination. If you have an imagination, you'll do A-OK. So if you guys want to join in, we really encourage it. If the players here want to play again too, you guys are more free to join in next time too if no one else wants to jump in on those characters. So you guys did great. Good job. Round of applause for everyone here. Round of applause.
Yes, and definitely you. Viewers, we are going to be looking for 4 more players for the next game that we do, so please, like Shanana said, feel free to stop by the Discord, and if you're interested, go ahead and voice your interest, and we might be looking for you for the next game.
Yeah, thank you, Timbo, for being our GM today. Round applause for you, too. Woo, yeah.
It's my pleasure.
And I know you guys probably have a lot of questions. We'll keep going over things each session. So don't feel scared about wanting to jump in and play, because I know it can be a little bit nervous at first, but I don't know. Do you guys feel a little bit more comfortable? I know you guys were a bit little.
Yeah, I was kind of
a little nervous in the beginning.
At first.
Yeah, a little bit.
But I actually had a little
better than you thought it would be.
I still have no idea what I'm doing.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, distractions. Anyways, it was really great. So yeah, definitely give us a follow. If you have any questions, send us a message. And thank you guys so much for playing with us. If you guys want to join in and no one decides to join in the next session, you guys are more than welcome to choose a different character, or if you want to play the same characters again, up to you guys. So
I'm in. Put me in, coach.
Yeah, so
All right. Thank you guys again. Well, thank you to all the viewers.
You guys all take care.
You too.
You guys have an awesome, stay awesome, amazing, and beautiful, all you guys. And hopefully we'll see you on the next sessions. Or next, yeah. Bye!